How great is God! The heavens declare his greatness. The skies displayed his awesome craftsmanship, exalted in power, majestic above all. For centuries, artists have portrayed angels as beautiful humans with wings and glowing light, complete with halos, harps and flowing white gowns. But is that what really angels look like? Do they seem mysterious to you? Do angels exist and serve man today? Are angels males or females? When did God create the angels? Do we have guardian angels? Is there an angel of death? Angels have inspired all sorts of imaginative stories and depictions. But what's left when we separate fact from fiction? In order to know the truth, we got to dive into the Bible. What does the Bible say about angels? Bible Frontier, Jivitache Utor, Educating the Body of Christ.
In today's episode, Jeshurun DeCruz will be answering questions put forth by our dearest viewers on angels.
So, welcome back to this last episode of the series on angels. And it's been really nice sharing with you. It's been really amazing sharing about angels and sharing things about the spirit realm. And even those who received Jesus in this last episode, I'm so happy for you, because Jesus will change your life for the better. He makes all things good. The Bible says he makes all things good in his time. Amen. I just want to share a few experiences of mine, and we will also ask for our eyes to be opened. And you believe, if you have received Jesus, you ask for your eyes to be opened, that you will be able to see into the spiritual realm and see angels and have experiences that God has designed for you to have. Okay, so we have a few questions that we will also deal with. So not every person has an angel. I believe the people who reject God, the angel that was with them has no purpose anymore. So the angel goes back to the Father. And there are many times that as I like, even when I walk out from this place and I pass the road, I see angels following people on their bikes. I see angels moving above cars, and many things that have happened. Like, there was a time where I saw angels. Actually, basically, there were like five angels formed in a flying motion in front of me, headed by one, and it was like an arrow pointing forwards as I was riding. And I realized why there were five angels with me at that particular point, and not just my one guardian angel, because there was a lot of demonic activity that was happening ahead when I moved ahead. I saw why those angels were there, because I saw like a congregation of demons, like in a particular place. And I see demons too, and they are very dark kind of creatures, very ugly animal kind of looking creatures. Like, they have it's like I was just explaining to someone here that the demons are very kind of ash color, ash gray color. and they are very like hideous to look at. But I saw these angels kind of moving in front of me, probably to dispel any kind of demons that were probably there in front of me. And I believe God sends his angels on assignments for many purposes, like especially when there is a lot of praise to demonic powers, or when there is like praise to any kind of demons, there are angels that are assigned in that particular place to actually dispel the darkness in that place as we pray. As we pray and as we call upon the Lord, he sends angels, and he sends angels to dispel darkness in particular places. I remember once when my dad was speaking on Sunday, I see this angel. Actually, he comes in front of this loudspeaker, and it's like basically he directs the sound of the speaker. And what I see coming out from his hands, and what he's directing the sound of the speaker. My dad was speaking on the mic, and he was sharing something from the Bible. What he directs from the speaker is like liquid color, and I see all this multicolored liquid. What he was directing, just hitting people, and it's like that liquid was saturating people. So there was this time I had like of there was an experience of an angel I saw doing something different. Like I've seen angels with swords. I've seen angels with trumpets, and they're very often, and when we meet on Sundays, and when we are praising and worshiping, I just see so many angels just come into that place at that time, and even surround that place that when we are praising and worshiping God, and as we sing and as we play music, the angels join in to worship the Father. I really believe that angels are attracted to places where we worship the Father. So anytime, even if you are just singing in your home, if you're singing a song of praise to God, angels will come into that place to worship with you and to praise God with you. So they are just attracted to worship. I've seen like huge angels, maybe around 12 to 15 feet tall. I mean, like warrior angels. They have a belt of solid gold, and they have a breastplate of gold, and they have huge massive forearms with a sword in their hands, and they actually stand in like a very kind of guard kind of way with authority, and the sword is standing up in their hands. I've seen them sometimes like moving in front of me. I've seen a couple of these angels move in front of me. I've seen a massive angel at the place where we stay. In fact, I've seen him on top of one of the trees there. He has a huge flaming sword in his hand and massive wings, and he looks upon this place where we stay in Mercedes. So I've seen this angel there, and there are many such experiences that I've had seen angels. I've seen angels come and touch people from the back, and suppose we are in a meeting, and sometimes when we are sharing or during praise and worship, I've seen an angel come behind a person and touch them on their back. I know that it sometimes it happens. I know that a person needs healing, so I would just pray for healing at that particular time. And I see an angel come and touch someone. I've seen angels massaging a person on his shoulders, and it so happened like that. I shared this when I saw this angel come and massage this particular man on his shoulders, and when I shared it to him, he was like, this is one of the things that I love, like massages. And God also gave me a full word of knowledge that came with this, and I told him that there is a kind of like pressure in your life, and there is stress that you are going through, and God wants you to know that His grace is sufficient for you, and be relaxed. And the angel is just causing you to be relaxed even physically, to not be stressed up. And that word was absolutely accurate for him. The word that I spoke to him, that God gave me, was absolutely accurate for him. So I've seen many things actually, and I've also seen some visions and things like that. And there are things that I've seen, like even when my dad speaks, like things in the spirit realm. Anytime he's speaking, like if I look in the spirit, I see actually swords coming up, coming out from his mouth as he speaks. And we know the Bible is called the sword of the spirit. So anyone who speaks the word of God, it's like you're speaking swords out. And all that the word of God, whenever you speak the word of God, it will accomplish what it is sent forth for. So the word of God is, I've realized even through all of this, the word of God is amazing and powerful. The things that even through this vision that I saw, that swords come out from a person's mouth when you speak from the word of God. And there have been countless experiences on this, but there's one thing like I would like to say is what is really, really very important, and what I've found to be the most pleasing, and the thing that satisfies me the most, is to have a relationship with the Father. And that the Father desires, or all that the Father desires, is for you to know Him. And He wants you to know Him as a father. God wants you to know Him as a father. He doesn't want to just be a God who is far distant away. And he wants your mind to change about who He is actually. And many times we kind of put God in the box, thinking that God is angry now and God is good now, and God is sometimes He is good, sometimes he's bad. But God wants you to know that He is good all the time. And the most important thing for God is to have a relationship with you. That is the most important thing that God thinks about, is to have a deep relationship with you, a relationship of a father and a son, for you to understand who he really is. Okay, so that is one of the things that I have realized even this journey through understanding angels. I've realized that God wants relationship much more than He wants you to know anything. So even if you don't see angels, or if you don't see anything of that sort, there is nothing wrong. Okay, the thing that God wants the most is relationship. Okay, and one thing is, this is what Paul says, the Apostle Paul says in one of the letters. He says, the mystery that has been hidden for ages has now been revealed. And that mystery that Paul speaks about is Christ in you, the hope of glory. And this means Jesus living inside of you, okay, is the hope of glory for the world, or even for God to be revealed. It's because Jesus lives inside of you. For those who believe, and for those who have received Jesus, you have to come to we have to come to a place of believing to such a deep extent that we believe that Christ living inside of us. Okay, and then we believe that as we touch people, or as we lay our hands upon the sick, they will recover, or for anything for that matter that Jesus did, we can do the very same thing that Jesus did, because He lives inside of us and His power lives inside of us. And that is the greatest thing ever, okay, for Jesus to live inside of us. So because He lives inside of us, we have the whole access to the spirit realm and all that. Okay, what I want to do is, I just want to just take a few questions, and we'll just see the few questions that were put up. And maybe you had a few of these questions, and we'll just go through them and see. Okay, so the first question is, do we become angels after we die? The answer is no. We do not become angels, because angels are a different being created by God, and we are a different being created by God. We are made in the likeness. We are made in the likeness and image of God. That's what Genesis says. And angels don't possess a physical body like we do. So Jesus becomes like us. In fact, Jesus becomes like us. And he proves to us. Jesus basically becomes man so that we can become like him is, like he is in his spiritual body. And we see that after Jesus is glorified, we see that Jesus has a supernatural body. He has a body that does everything that he did basically on the earth, and he appears to his disciples. So no, after we die, we become like who Jesus is in his resurrected body. Okay, so is there an angel of death? Now is there an angel of death, or do angels kill people? Now it is mentioned in the Bible that in 2 Samuel 24:12-17, it mentions the story where the angel stretches out his hand and he kills when David was king in that place, and he kills a large amount of people in that particular place. Now we don't know whether God specifically has angels to kill people, but I think, but there is, according to the purpose of God and according to his will, when there is something that has to be done, like some human races were eliminated, even there were places where these when Jehoshaphat, he was going out with his army, and they send out the singers and the musicians, and the Lord sets ambushes against the enemy. Now we know that the enemy was destroyed and the enemy was killed, and I believe the enemy was killed by angels in that place, and because the people didn't fight, Jehoshaphat's army didn't fight in that place. They only and the Lord set ambushes against them. Now we know that angels can kill people, but there is no specific mention of an angel of death in the Bible. This is not like one separate angel. Okay, are there child angels? Are there child angels? No, there are no child angels. The angels don't experience age like we do. They are a spirit being. What God has created, they last forever. That's the reason also I believe why demons cannot be killed, because they don't have an age. They are spirit beings, even like us. We are a spirit being, so even once our life is over on the earth, it doesn't mean we just cease to exist. We either live separated from God or with God forever. Okay, can angels read our mind? I don't believe angels can read our mind, because only the Father knows our hearts. The word says he knows our hearts, he knows our intentions, he knows our thoughts. Okay, I don't believe angels read our mind. They don't have the authority, or they don't have that access over us, but they can see our actions, and they can see how we act in particular ways and things like that. But I don't think so. They can read our mind. There's nothing mentioned like that in the word. Okay, there's a very interesting question. Like, if guardian angels exist, why do they still let bad things happen to us? Now it's a very interesting question, but I would just say a lot of bad things that happen in the world is because the world, or there are many people in the world who don't really love God, and the world has been corrupted because of sin into many places. Now angels don't have the permission, or they don't have the access to change everything in the world, and they cannot make the world right. In fact, we have to make the world right by being who we are actually in Jesus. We have to be who Jesus is actually. The word says, there's one verse that says, as Jesus is, so are we on the earth. So we have to be his body, because he has made us one with him. We have to be who he is, and that is what changes the world. So there are many things that happen bad on the earth, and we know that since the fall of man, the earth has not been the same. God had created everything perfectly for mankind. We know that animals also fight with each other and hurt each other and things like that. So we know the very perfection that God had created doesn't exist anymore. Okay, so this is there's another question here. It says, when believers pray for unbelievers for angelic protection, do angels surround them? Okay, now if you realize that believers, the Bible says Jesus has given us authority, okay, and what we speak, and even in the previous episodes I said this, what we speak comes to pass, because life and death is in the power of the tongue, especially for those who believe, okay. And it is like this: nothing is impossible for those who believe. This is also what the word says: nothing is impossible for those who believe. So when you declare something over someone, when you declare that, Lord, I pray that this person be protected by angels, it will happen, okay. And in fact, it is really important that we do this and we speak things of life over other people, or we speak protection over other people, especially who don't believe, because they don't have any means of protecting themselves, okay, especially from the enemy or from the devil. They have no means, because they don't have the power of Christ living inside of them. But since we are joined to Christ and we are one with Jesus, we can speak protection for people, and angels are sent to protect them in times like this. Also, recently I was just speaking to someone, and they were talking about how they had a dream of someone meeting with an accident, and it really came to pass after they dreamt that. And I believe that the Lord, now that some person that they saw meeting with an accident wasn't a person who believed in Jesus. And I believe that the Lord shows us something so that we can pray for that particular situation, and we can speak angelic protection over those over that person that we saw in our dream. So if the Lord, if you believe in Jesus, and if the Lord has shown you certain things about certain events that probably could happen, or even for your family, and if you're concerned about your family, if you're concerned about your children, if you're concerned about if you're concerned about your family who yet does not believe in Jesus, you can speak angelic protection over them, okay, especially for specific purposes. And sometimes and anything, like even if they go away from us, we can speak protection of angels over them, and the Lord will cause that to come to pass. Because why? Because of us who believe. And since we believe and we speak, that will come to pass for them. So yeah, angels can be sent, and you can ask angels to protect the people that you love, or the people that who don't yet believe in Jesus. Okay, so it has been really nice speaking about this whole series on angels, and this is my first time speaking into a camera. Please excuse me for not being very clear sometimes, and expressing things maybe really well, but it's been nice talking. It's been a good experience for me. Even as I've studied on angels, I've learned so much more from this time of teaching and even sharing with you. So be encouraged to know God more. I would just say, keep the main thing in your mind is to know God more. Okay, to know him as Father, to not know him as a God who is far away from us, but to know him as a close Father who is there with you at all times, and he is with you. And to know Jesus as he lives inside of you, whether you have received Jesus, and if you have received Jesus, that is your right to know that Jesus lives inside of you, okay, and his power lives inside of you. So that is the only thing I want to leave you with. Be encouraged to know that God loves you and He has a great plan for your life. Even seeing into the spiritual realm is for our good, so that we can know Him more. Okay, everything should lead to this one thing of us knowing God more. So thank you for watching this program. Thank you for joining me, and I would like to thank Rophe TV for having me on this show and allowing me to just share my experiences and share the things that I've seen with you. Thank you once again.
How great is God! The heavens declare His greatness. The skies displayed His awesome craftsmanship, exalted in power, majestic above all. For centuries, artists have portrayed angels as beautiful humans with wings and glowing light, complete with halos, harps and flowing white gowns. But is that what really angels look like? Do they seem mysterious to you? Do angels exist and serve man today? Are angels males or females? When did God create the angels? Do we have guardian angels? Is there an angel of death? Angels have inspired all sorts of imaginative stories and depictions. But what's left when we separate fact from fiction? In order to know the truth, we got to dive into the Bible. What does the Bible say about angels? Bible Frontier, Jivitacha Uttar, educating the body of Christ.
We believe you have been blessed hearing this 7th series on angels. For more life-changing, informative and highly inspirational programs, keep watching Rophe TV.